Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist. I want to try some new sunscreens. Every year I kind of like renew my sunscreen stash, which, you know, there's not a lot left over because I use it everywhere, every day, all the time. So I go through sunscreens like this. I got some requested sunscreens, some new sunscreens, and some sunscreens that I'm just interested in. Sunscreens that are hopefully gonna make the application process easier whilst I'm out and about. But yes, we're gonna open them all, try them over a series of days. I've only got 3 spaces on my face really to try these sunscreens. And listen, don't worry about me wasting these. I'm gonna open all of them. And if I don't like them, they go on my body and they all get used up. Trust me, I use a lot of sunscreen. So we have to talk about the new version of Beet Te Sun from Krave Beauty. Krave Beauty's Beet Te Sun is a lightweight chemical sunscreen, broad spectrum SPF 40, PA 3 pluses with beetroot, hyaluronic acid, and vitamin E. Devastated when this was taken off the market, but completely understand why. I don't know really the differences between this one and the other one, other than that the SPF rating and PA rating is gonna meet what it says on the packaging. So I'm expecting the same lightweight, fluidy product that I came to know and love. My skin's a little bit irritated already. Not from this sunscreen, from something else. So I am worried sunscreen might irritate my skin a little bit. Oh, yes, that's so nice. To me, it feels the same. Maybe a little bit thicker. Yeah, maybe a little bit thicker, but it's nothing that's gonna ruin the experience of it for me. I'd like to see how it kind of plays out during the day, which we will do today. We'll see if my oily forehead is going to get greasy or not. Oh, I like that. It's got that smooth kind of finish to it. No stinging of the skin. There are some chemical based sunscreens at the moment I use them. I can feel irritation on my skin, especially where I've already got breakouts and irritation. But no, that feels nice. It feels nice. It's not the same. It's new. And I like it. Next up, another fellow YouTuber. This is Naturium Dew Glow Moisturizer SPF 50, a broad spectrum chemical sunscreen with niacinamide and 3-O-ethyl ascorbic acid to help visibly improve complexion. For those of us in the UK, it is on Soko Glam, and you can get this through Soko Glam. They also sell in Space NK, but not all their products right now. Now, I have seen people of all skin tones using this. Doesn't smell like anything. I thought there'd be a sunscreeny smell. Oh, this is nice. This feels like a moisturizer. Beard test. Perfect, thank you. Oh God, and that does go on invisible. Invisible, like you don't see anything. I'm gonna put close the eyes to see if it stings as well. It's not overly dewy. It's a nice natural dewy glow, which I really, really enjoy. Yeah, again, it looks invisible on the skin. It feels nice and moisturizing. Both of these actually are something I would use as a moisturizer, you know, instead of doubling up moisturizer than sunscreen in the warmer months. Again, I like that. I'll check in a bit later. And we'll see how my skin's doing. Right, last one on this face for today is gonna be Bondi Sands Sunny Days Hydrating SPF 50 Moisturizer. They call it a non-ghosting sunscreen that is enriched with vitamin E, wild hibiscus extract, and zinc oxide to provide up to 72 hours of hydration and protection. Zinc oxide sunscreens and the word plump aren't usually ones I link together. Now, I've had one of these last year and I gave it away in like a giveaway box. So this is actually the first time. I've been meaning to try it for a year. So this is the first time I'll be using. Oh. So it's also tinted, which doesn't usually work on my skin. Although I do look very like pale, lighter skinned. If it's not the exact browny, undertoney kind of-ness, it can look a little bit like weird foundation and a bit orangey on my skin. So I'll be interested to see how this looks. Oh. Oh. That's like completely disappeared. I also don't see a white cast. I'll have to look at it away from my monitor. A bit more. Let's layer this up a bit more. I like that. Where is it? It's gone. That is a good match for my skin tone. I like that a lot. I've been putting off using that for like a year. Okay, so I've got a few things to do today. I'm gonna wear these throughout the day, half and half on my nose and here, and then my oily kind of forehead. So Krave's got a bit of work to do, especially on my oily forehead, but we do also have the Naturium and the Bondi Sands sunscreen on my oily nose. So we'll see how my skin reacts to them throughout the day, and I'll check in with you in a bit. Okay, so it's about 5 hours later. I've been working, I've walked the dogs twice, so I'm feeling a little bit flushed. One thing I will say is I uploaded the earlier footage onto my computer, and you can see how irritated my skin is at the moment. And I will say about all three of these, because usually I avoid sunscreen if my skin is irritated, all three of these have not irritated my skin in any way whatsoever. In fact, they feel really comfortable on the skin. I'm a little bit worn out from walking. I did a long walk, but I'm not greasy on my forehead at all. I'm not greasy either side. Oh, actually, I'm a little bit here, but I think that's actually sweat. But they've all held up really, really well. I'm really actually impressed by the Bondi Sands Sunny Days, because I do not like tinted moisturizers, sunscreens. Everyone other than the Undefined Beauty one has been awful on my skin. It looks like I got tan caught in my hairline, like it's really, really bad. But I've been like really impressed by all of these. No stinging whatsoever. I don't expect stinging for me from a zinc sunscreen. So yeah, two chemical sunscreens. They pretty much have the same active ingredients as well. Really, really like those. I mean, they're standard. They're gonna be my go-to. Really impressed with this one. I think I'm gonna use this one when I want my skin to look a little bit fresher. Days where I do have irritated skin, where I'd rather not be using a chemical sunscreen. Sunscreen in general, but I might have to. This will probably be my go-to. Okay, so I just want to add this bit in because I filmed this video, the whole video, a couple of days ago, and since then I have used both the Naturium sunscreen and the Krave sunscreen separately, a full day all over my face. The Naturium one held up really, really well. Again, it just felt like a moisturizer on my skin, and especially my very oily nose. Was absolutely fine. It wasn't a particularly strenuous day for me or a hot day or anything like that, so I still felt really nice on the skin, not irritating, no eye stinging. The Krave Beauty one, same story. Again, if you love the Beet Shield or Beet Te Sun, you're gonna love it, whatever your skin type. In my opinion, very oily nose, struggle a bit with oils on the forehead and dry patches. Absolutely fine, absolutely fine. So I just want to say that I kind of gave both a fair trial all over my face, because I feel like they're going to be some of my go-tos. I was going to wait till tomorrow to try more, but I feel like now is a good time to test sunscreen sticks and reapplication sunscreens. So these are sunscreen products I would use to reapply sunscreen throughout the day. Yes, you can just take your sunscreen and reapply. However, I like the idea of sunscreen sticks and compacts in order to make the whole process a lot easier. So the state my skin is in at the moment, with a layer of sunscreen, a little bit oily, is how I would be reapplying sunscreen. I do have the Bring Green Tea Tree Cica Tone Up Sun Cushion. Tone up is gonna be white on me. Tone up is not for anybody else other than people with white skin. It also has a greenish cast to it. So I already know this is gonna be too light for my skin. And this is the issue with a lot of compact sunscreens. And most compacts I find are actually mineral sunscreens. They have zinc in them, so they do come off as a purely white zinc based sunscreen. But I do have another compact I'd like to try, and then I have the AHC Masters Rich Air Sun Stick. So two for one here from Olive Young. I'm gonna go in with the AHC one first, because I don't believe it's gonna leave a white cast on my skin. AHC Masters Air Rich Sun Stick, SPF 50+, PA 4+, they say ensures all-day skin hydrating and waterproof effects with light application, has Centella Asiatica to help hydrate and soothe the skin, and calamine to help prevent any shine whilst controlling sebum. Look at this packaging! Masters Air Rich Sun Stick. I got this because it was, this just feels so expensive. Just because it was like on the popular page of Olive Young, so I was like, why not? And I love the shape. I do love a teardrop shape sun stick. I just find it easier to apply. It looks a bit lemon cakey. Okay, let's go. I'm gonna go this side. Ooh. Goes on so smoothly. The shape that allows me to get into all those awkward areas. I am a little bit irritated here where I'm pushing so hard. I have very reactive skin, especially with rosacea here. So whilst it looks like I'm damaging it. I'm not doing it. Like, I look like I'm really irritating it. The redness will go down in a bit. A nice silky smooth finish. I really like that.
Yeah, I like that as a reapplication kind of stick.
It does have a lemony, like almost like a yuzu smell to it, which I don't really like. But feels nice.
Yeah, I like that on the skin.
Let's get into these compacts because I know they're going to be a problem. This is huge. They're always so huge as well. So this is the BRTC. I've ripped it apart now. BRTC Mild Sun Cushion is a zinc oxide based sunscreen with centella asiatica leaf, madicasside, madicassic acid and asiatica side, and asiatic acid to soothe irritated skin and add moisture to healthy skin. Little mirror up there. And you can see it's pure white. Like, this is going to be an issue. So I'm going to go here. I wish, because it's so easy to reapply like this. I wouldn't have this as my first application, but I would definitely reapply. Yeah, that is white. You get a really nice even spread with these kind of like compact applications, but there, for me, I don't feel like you're getting enough as a first layer of sunscreen. Like, I definitely have to use a normal sunscreen to start the day. Then if I'm sitting outside, at home, no one's seeing me, I will pile this on. You know what I mean? In the garden, I don't care how white I look, but the whole point is to kind of be able to touch up on the go. I feel like if I covered my whole face with this, I could probably get away with it, and my neck too, but it is giving me a very pale cast. Very white. Not surprising. As I said, I will keep this. Going to my parents for a barbecue, sitting in the garden, pottering around the house, I will keep this. Okay, and the last one is this one. Bring Green Tea Tree Cica Tone Up Sun Cushion. They say the product tones up the skin without leaving greasy feelings. However, that would mean a white cast. With tea tree extract and centella asiatica to help soothe the skin. Because again, it is going to be white. That is my fault though, because it says tone up in the name. I know exactly what tone up is, so I don't know why I just chose to ignore it. I think the green attracted me because I was like, green is supposed to cancel out red and I get very rosacea prone skin. So I thought that might work fine. But yeah, it's just white again, isn't it? I don't think it's as bad as the other one from what I can see. I'm just going to go put it on the bit where I did the application stick just to see sunscreen stick, just to see if I even it out, if I can get away with it. My nose looks really red in comparison to everything. I actually don't know. I feel like I'm gonna put this into Final Cut Pro and see how white it really is. I think, like, if, you know, if I'm out and about or I'm sitting in the sun, which I never am, if I'm in a garden and I just wanted to protect my rosacea prone cheeks, I can put a bit on and just like blend it out a bit. And hopefully no one will know. I don't know. What do you think? I actually don't know. If it's like a screen grab of this colour, then a screen grab of this colour, I'm sure they are very... Yeah, they are. That's very pale.
I wish someone invent a chemical sunscreen in this form. You don't DIY them. You don't take out one sunscreen and put it into a compact and make a compact sunscreen, because sunscreen packaging is very carefully thought through. So yeah. Oh, that's bad. Okay, tomorrow I'm going to be applying 3 more sunscreens. Hello, it's officially tomorrow, like the next day.
It's confusing.
My skin is feeling a little bit less irritated. I did a very minimal skincare routine last night using my go-to COSRX Cica serum to help soothe and calm everything, and my Asturia barrier cream. Love it. Whenever my skin is feeling bad, like, that's my go-to combination after cleansing, and that's it. So today I'm trying those 3 sunscreens. Let's start off with a nice Birdie Up Sun Dr. G by Dr. G SPF 50 plus PA 4 pluses. They say contains a sebum control complex to help the skin stay dry and soft. Packed with antioxidants, this also has ceramides in, niacinamide and sodium hyaluronate. Now, I'm pretty sure this is made for people who do actually do golf, go golfing. I don't know how to discuss sport, because you're out in the sun all day, you're under the sun all day. So I do expect this to be quite a thick kind of sunscreen. This is a long-lasting sun cream that blocks sweat, oil, and even sand up to the 18th hole without crumbling. Let's see, I'm gonna do this on my forehead because I feel like it's the most real estate. No scent, which is actually quite nice, because a lot of the Korean sunscreens I use usually have like a lemony scent. There is no white cast at all. This is a mineral sunscreen, no? Zinc oxide seems to be the only sunscreen in here. That's so nice. No, let me try it. Let me like put another layer on. Just make sure there's not a lot in here. I can feel it's mostly air. No, I like this a lot. Listen, if you have darker skin, this will probably potentially give you a white cast, but I can't see one on myself. I really like that. I really like that. It doesn't feel or look overly dewy. It feels like it's going to become a little bit silky once it settles on my skin. It will be interesting to see later as my oils produce, especially on my forehead, how oily my skin gets. But no, I'm really impressed with that. Unfortunately, I don't have any sand to test it on. I really like that. I really like this a lot. I was expecting this to be a thick, pasty, zinc-based sunscreen, especially as it's meant to be for those outside all day. I thought it was just gonna be really thick and horrible. It has Braille on the side up here too. I'm keeping this one out. So let's try the Purito. Purito Daily Soft Touch Sunscreen is a vegan broad spectrum chemical sunscreen, SPF 50+, PA 4+. Infused with 5 different types of ceramides, it helps strengthen the skin barrier, keeping hydration locked in. Also containing Centella Asiatica to calm and soothe sensitive and irritated skin with zero white cast. I mentioned that I was able to try this a little bit. I actually only tried it on my hands. And when it was on my hands, it was nice and light, cast free. So it'll be good to see how this goes on here. Again, no smell at all. And I say all do and I'm just not smelling anything. Goes on just like a really nice, creamy moisturizer. Really nice. A bit of a sticky finish, but nothing unlike a moisturizer would leave you with kind of thing. Again, really, really nice, like a really nicely elegant to use formulation. I'll be interested to see how this works on my irritated skin because it has got ceramides in. We know ceramides are meant to help along with your skin barrier's natural healing process. And it is a matte sunscreen, okay, that's meant to help strengthen the skin barrier. So this could be an irritated skin friendly sunscreen. I'll let you know in the next 5 hours. And I will be reapplying these. I forgot to mention, I have been reapplying these every couple of hours. Okay, and the last one is going to be the CKD Green Propolis All Mild Sun Up UV SPF 50+, PA 4+. Again, this is a mineral sunscreen, broad spectrum, the zinc formula. They say it has 3 skin benefits, including anti-wrinkle, brightening, and of course, sun protection. They say their featured ingredients include triple block TM technology, which ensures protection from UVA and UVB rays, the removal of sweat and sebum, and the formation of a zinc layer. Interesting claims. I got this from Olive Young. What I like about the Olive Young, what I love about Olive Young is they usually come in these special sets where you get like a mini travel friendly one. So I'm gonna open this first in case I don't like it. And where are we going? Going this one. Looks very white. It has a smell to it, but I don't know what that is. It just kind of smells clean. And here we go. This is a classic mineral sunscreen. This is what I kind of expected from the Dr. G, what's it called? Nice Birdie one. And as you can see, it's all like going in my facial hair. So this is already a no, but that's fine. That's fine. I think that is rubbing in really nicely. Let me add another layer. I am using a fair bit. So really, you know, that was enough just if I was covering this one side of my face. But I just want to see, because it's rubbing in quite nicely. So I wonder if it just takes a bit of work. I say that, it's not going through the facial hair nicely at all. I will say that's actually rubbed onto the skin really, really nicely. Obviously, if you do have darker skin, you will probably see a white cast. For me, I can definitely get away with it. My issue is now this. What's all this?
What am I meant to do now?
So I'm going to have to go get my beard brush and kind of rub that in. So I won't be reapplying this one because I do not think it's for me. I don't have time to be fussing around in my facial hair at the very last step of my routine. I will be reapplying the Purito and the Dr. G sunscreen twice before I check in with you next. So we see how they're holding up with my oily skin, oily T-zone, and my slightly drier cheek as well. Hello, so it's roughly 5.5 hours later. I've had a busy day. I've gone out walking again. And honestly, I'm so impressed by the two sunscreens. I gave up on this one. It was too chalky and too white. But the Nice Birdie by Dr. G, I've actually reapplied twice. Matte, no white cast, like kind of build up for a zinc sunscreen. It's really nice. It's just nice and elegant. And my skin feels not matte, it feels moisturized, but with a silky finish. It's hard to describe, and it's been like that all day. Really, really, really nice. I really like that. It's one of my new favorites. The same pretty much with the Purito. I did get a little bit oilier on my oily nose with this. Reapplied and it was absolutely fine. I kind of got oily, I would say, towards the last like half hour before applying this, but absolutely fine. Absolutely fine. So I've got like six sunscreens I absolutely love. So I want to recap them. Obviously, the Krave Beauty Beet Te Sun. If you like the original, you're gonna love this one. Yes, I do think it's a little bit thicker than the previous one, but if you have oily skin, it's nothing really to worry about. You're not gonna see a huge difference in how your skin deals with it throughout the day. A little bit of a difference in the formulation, in my opinion, from what I can gather. It's Beet Te Sun. If you liked it before, you're gonna love it again. Naturium Dew Glow Moisturizer SPF 50. I was a little bit hesitant about this one on my oily T-zone because I can't remember where I saw it, but another skincare influencer said that they don't think oily people would like it. My oily T-zone was absolutely fine, especially the corners here where I get really, really greasy. Absolutely fine, absolutely fine. Honestly, no different to me using one of my favorite gel moisturizers. Very nice, very, very nice. A pleasant surprise from Bondi Sands Sunny Days. I didn't realize that it was tinted. I didn't realize really that it was zinc based. Absolutely love it, absolutely love it. No cast on me, but that is because I do think the tint suits my skin perfectly. It just happened to be a perfect match for my skin. Again, absolutely love this. We'll probably use this when my skin needs a bit of a pick-me-up, when it is looking a little bit uneven, a little bit sensitive like it is at the moment. I would use this to give myself a bit more of like an even glow. As a reapplication sunscreen, the AHC Masters Air Rich Sun Stick SPF 50 Plus PA 4 Pluses is so good. It's so nice. It has a slight mattifying effect to the skin, but nothing crazy if you still like a dewy glow. You're still going to have nice, natural, glowy skin, but this will take care of any of like excess greasy oils. Really easy to apply with that almost teardrop shape to it. So you get in all the crevices, no eye stings, works around the ears, back of the ears, around the neck. Perfectly. I love this as a reapplicator. I think possibly not my favorite. No, I think it's my favorite, but only because I'm the most surprised by it. And that is the Nice Birdie Up Sun by Dr. G. Again, on me, zero white cast. If you have darker skin, you might notice the white cast. But for me, this matte but still glowy finish of my forehead that I feel does help take care of my natural greasiness and oils throughout the day. Loved it. So I'm very oily here, but very dry around here, and it's not been too drying for my skin whatsoever. And that also goes for the Purito Daily Soft Touch Sunscreen. Again, dry here, oily here, and it's handled both different types of skin perfectly. Upon reapplication again, it didn't feel heavy. It helped kind of like refresh the look of my skin from going to greasy and oily to kind of like naturally glowy, but with a slight matte finish. I can't believe I'm enjoying matte finishes when it comes to sunscreens. And of course, special shout out for the Beauty of Joseon Matte Sun Stick. Again, another perfect reapplicator throughout the day. If you really do struggle with shiny greasiness, this is the one to go for. Obviously disappointed by the compacts. I wish there was a way that compacts could be... There must be chemical sunscreen compacts out there, right? If not, there must be a reason. I don't know. Let me know in the comments down below. Let me know the sunscreens that you've been loving as well in the comments. And you can check out some more product reviews here and some general light entertainment here. And I'll see you over there.